Why does the moon keep flashing us? These mysterious moon flashes are still unexplained, and it's something that has to be resolved before any more moon missions or colonies can be placed on the moon. So what can these be? This is by Rafi Letzer on space.com. There's something flashing us on the moon, and we don't know what it is. But that might be about to change. We've known about these mysterious flashes since at least the 1960s, when astronomers Barbara Middlehurst and Patrick Moore reviewed the scientific literature. That's when they found nearly 400 reports of strange events that took place on the moon. Small regions of the lunar surface would get suddenly brighter or darker without obvious explanation. The scientists' survey of the flashes and dimming, which they called lunar transient phenomena, was published in the journal Science on January 27, 1967. Later, astronomers flipped the words around, terming the events transient lunar phenomena instead of lunar transient phenomena. The emitted light is usually described as reddish or pinkish, sometimes with a sparkling or flowing appearance. This is what another astronomer, A.A. Mills, in March 1970 wrote in the journal Nature magazine. The coloration may extend for a distance of 10 miles or more on the lunar surface, with brighter spots 2 to 3 miles across, and it's commonly associated with veiling of the surface features. The average duration of an event is some 20 minutes, but it may persist intermittently for a few hours. Amateur astronomers can sometimes spot the flares with the help of a decent telescope, though the flares are unpredictable, and finding one can involve hours or days of waiting. Mills noted, bafflingly, that the events leave no obvious marks on the lunar surface after they passed. Scientists have returned to the subject periodically in these past 50 years, but without turning up any conclusive explanations as to what is causing them. These events are now known to happen a few times every week. This year, a new team of astronomers has returned to the question with an observatory specially designed for this task. The new instrument observed the moon constantly using two cameras located 60 miles north of Seville in Spain. When both cameras spot a flash, according to the statement from the telescope's designers, they record detailed photos and videos of the events and send the email to Julius Maximilians Universitat in Bavaria, Germany, which runs the telescope. The observatory is still under development, according to the statement, with ongoing improvements to its software since it went online in April. Still, researchers have their suspicions as to what this will discover. Seismic activities, they say, were also observed on the moon. When the surface moves, gases that reflect sunlight could escape from the interior of the moon itself. Hakan Kayal, researcher of JMU and head of telescope projects, said in the statement, quote, "This would explain the luminous phenomena, some of which last for hours," Kayal said. And given current plans to establish a base on the moon, it's important to know just what is going on up there, so folks living at the base can be prepared for their environment. But even if that base never happens, I think it will, it would be nice to know why the moon keeps flashing at us. If you'd like to join me on my Patreon account, you will hear content not covered by mainstream media. These riveting stories will be based on my research, and I will state my opinions and give my personal insight on diverse and controversial subjects and world events not covered by mainstream media, and not certainly on not supported by YouTube guidelines. So whatever I have on my Patreon, most of those will not be on my YouTube channel. Please consider becoming a member today. More of the most significant and important videos will be on my Patreon channel. Your support helps me to continue my research and keeps this YouTube channel alive. And we depend on your support, your generous charity, because we help economically challenged families here in Athens, Greece, in Kapota, and we also help the young generation with university tuition and the community around our church. Thank you.